River, and we shot some video with Sky Drone 13 from the Richwood area this morning. This is where residents there are under mandatory evacuation orders. I know so many folks want to see what does it look like in my area, and we are working to get you more video as soon as we can.
They just want to see what's going on, right? So the water along the Brazos in parts of Brazoria County is not expected to recede for days. Eyewitness News reporter Natasha Barrett joins us now live from the West Columbia area with the very latest. Natasha?
Hey guys, well, I just want to show you what I'm seeing here. And this is street after street. Look at this. There's several homes along here just surrounded by water. That home over there, Sean Rudy, I know it's been passed down in the family for 41 years. They've been trying to keep water out of it. Now about 12 inches of water in there. And the people have been trying to get their family photos out. I mean, there's nothing they can do about this. We're finally getting back here to West Columbia because the roads have been blocked for so long and were dangerous for us to get back here. We had to drive in circles, in fact, to find these neighborhoods. I want to take you up to Sky Eye now. Sky Eye caught some images earlier today of the entire area of West Columbia, and gosh, they got it bad, guys. That's the only way to put it. And it's going to be a while before they can clean things up here. We've concentrated a lot, you know, around Houston because we could kind of get around, but finally we're getting to these smaller areas of Brazoria County, and it breaks your heart to see even more of these desperate situations. There was a rescue today, not too far from where I am right now on Highway 35, a guy in his pickup truck. They had to go out and get him, and it looked like he was just in the middle of a river, but he got out safely. There was a crew nearby, thank goodness, got him on a boat and got him to safety. So, you know, you think it's kind of over with all the rescues we've seen, but maybe that's the problem, because people think we're so many days past all of this that they feel like, okay, I can drive through that road, I'll be fine, but around here, I can definitely say probably not, because it's taken us a lot to get around. I want to show you also the house that's over here. They put in one of those aqua dams around the perimeter of the home. Right now, there's no water in that house. But I mean, just look around. They've got a barn out back. And as you look at the land, it just looks like a swamp out of Louisiana. It's that bad. You would think it's always been this way, but no. And, you know, what people are worried about now is what's in this water. Mosquitoes breeding. Who knows what they'll bring as far as a public health concern. You've got alligators in people's homes. We've heard many reports of that. Snakes, spiders. So if you don't have to go in the water up here, just don't, because even with your boots, something's going to seep in, and it's just not a good idea. Another concern further back here, you would think that that's a dead end where that guy is wading through the water. We thought it was a dead end at first. There's houses back there, and then further over in that direction, there's an RV park. Those people got out okay a couple days ago, but beyond that, there's some sort of sewage treatment facility, and that's what everybody's worried about that's in the water now. So think about that mixed in with everything else that I told you about. You're not going to want to go in these waters. The people also who live out here say that they need more help. They would like to receive more help from their county officials. They feel like they're a little forgotten with what's happened all around town. So just passing along what they had to say. Live from West Columbia out here, Natasha Barrett, 13 Eyewitness News.
Yeah, and that's exactly why we got out there. I know we were receiving a lot of messages from people saying, hey, don't forget about us here in Brazoria County, because for so many of them, their situation is still getting worse. So I know that, you know, the volunteers and the rescuers are trying to get everywhere, but they certainly have their hands up there. Natasha, I'm just wondering about this aqua dam, because this is just amazing that it is holding through all that water. In all the driving around that you've done, is this pretty much the first one you've seen, or have you seen more?
Actually, what was it on Highway 35, Rudy? I think we started seeing it. I said, whoa, what's that? I hadn't seen that yet before. So we saw some along the highway. We're going to slowly turn the camera around for you here. Here's another one showing that house. And then even the next door's neighbor's house, I don't know if you can get that vantage point, Rudy, they've got another one. So, oh my goodness, if anything, let's all go in for these, for the next thing we're going to get, because they've been holding out. I don't know about that house to the right. I think they're okay. Obviously, the water's receded. I don't know if they ever got any water in them, but I need to know how much these things cost, right?
Great.
I think everybody wants to go in for this. Get the jar out, start saving, because that house is doing okay. But, you know, just a... Was it an hour ago it started raining out here? About an hour ago, I saw sprinkles, and we were all thinking, oh my goodness, and I think the people who live up here feel the same way. It's like, stop, please, just for a second, because they're just beginning to get out here and seeing their homes, and there's several people, because I talked about, you know, there's lots of nice land surrounded by these homes. People pass these homes down to, you know, their families throughout the line, and A lot of people have evacuated to Louisiana, and that home over there, I know it's been in the family for almost 45 years, that one, that orange one, and mom and dad, who are in their 70s, are in Lake Charles, and they haven't seen their home yet. So it just breaks your heart to think, you know, they're going to come home to this. And mosquitoes. See, we've got mosquitoes out here, so get your bug spray, for sure. That's a problem.
Yeah, it is heartbreaking. Yes, we'll be slapping our arms and legs for the next several weeks after all this rain. Natasha Barrett there live in the West Columbia area that has been hard hit. We now want to turn to Crosby, where the